What's up, internet friends? Today, I want to show you how to create a scrollable text block like this. Now, something like this would be really good for a transcript for a podcast, maybe a transcript for a YouTube video. If you ever have a lot of text that you want to add to your page so it gets indexed by Google, but you don't want it to make the entire page super long and scrolly, this is a great little workaround where you can sort of encapsulate that group of text and make it scrollable. So this is what we're going to be going over today. Let's jump in. Okay, so for adding the code, over on my website, look for the scrollable transcript block. I'll put a link to this article down below. What we need to do is grab this code right here, add it into our custom CSS area, and then target the text block so this code will apply to that text block and make it scrollable. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna hit copy right here. Let's go back to our website. Go to the custom CSS area on your website. So that is in website, all the way down here, website tools, and then custom CSS. Then what I wanna do is just paste that right in there. So this is good. This is sort of the template for the code that will make our transcript text right here. All of this, we want this to be scrollable. So the only thing I need to do now is target this text block right here and replace our block ID with the block ID of this text block. So I can see that this is a text box. If I go into the editor mode, you can see this whole thing is just one block of text right there. So I need to target that block. Squarespace adds these unique IDs to each block we add on our page, and we can target those using the block ID. Thankfully, we don't need to go in the web inspector and do a bunch of code stuff to figure out what it is. We can just turn on our Squarespace ID finder. Now, if you don't have this, you can find that. Go to the Chrome Web Store, download the Squarespace ID Finder by Heather Tovey. She created this. It's a really free, easy tool. Just hit Add to Chrome and it should pop up right there. So let's go back to our website, turn on the Squarespace ID Finder, grab that block ID and replace it right here. And now there we go. Now we have our scrollable text block with just some default values. Now you can change anything over here that starts with two dashes. We can change the border thickness. We can go back down to zero, maybe if we don't want one. We don't want any maybe padding, which is the internal spacing around there. We can sort of pull that edge to edge. Change this however you would like. I'm gonna leave this back, the styles I did have. The track, the scroll bar track, which is white right now, which is all this, and then the scroll bar color itself, which is that. You can adjust any of these however you like. So that's how you get this going. If you are creating a podcast or a YouTube channel, there's a good chance you want to do this on more than one web page. So let's duplicate this, right? Because this is probably kind of the template of our podcast or our YouTube channel of each episode. So I'm going to duplicate this, pretending we have another podcast episode. So here's our duplicated page. And then as I scroll down, you see it's not getting applied. It's getting applied to our original one right here. But not to our new one, our duplicated one. And that's because each block ID in Squarespace is unique. So the block ID that we've targeted in our website tools, custom CSS area, this is unique for the text block on that one page. So if we wanna add this style to another text block on another page, just need to turn on Squarespace ID Finder, grab that, add a comma after this block ID from the other one, but before our curly bracket, add a comma, line break, and then paste in the new one. And this is how we can add multiple, we can target multiple blocks just by separating each block ID with a comma. Very easy. All right, so that's how this code works. Let me know if you have any questions. We'd be happy to help out wherever we can. And if you want additional customizations for your Squarespace website, check out my plugin store with 25 plus different plugins, individual licenses with business licenses. You can do a bunch of different things to your Squarespace website. All right, that's it. Take it easy.